But in the very early design slides for Oscar, we actually said, oh, we should be an asset-light insurance company. So originally, the idea was always we want to be on our own paper, as the industry calls it, meaning we want to have our own capital, our own balance sheet, and so on, to be able to make decisions more quickly and decide what we want to reimburse and pay for and so on. But the idea was, like you're building a software project, let's get the best APIs, you know, let's get the best platforms to connect to and work on, et cetera. We thought that's how you can build an insurance company very early on. And that decidedly is not the case. And there's really two reasons for it. And we had to learn some of these over the years. Reason number one is sort of obvious. When you go and work with vendors that attach themselves to payers in the industry, whether it's a pharmacy benefits manager that negotiates drug prices for you, whether it's a network of physicians sometimes, whether it is other things like a utilization management vendor. These are the guys who sort of like use standardized metrics of medical decision making to determine whether to say yes or no to procedure requests and so on. You wouldn't expect these guys to be particularly technical. I can tell you some hilarious stories about the lack of technicality with some of these vendors. We had one vendor actually very early on. We told him beforehand, I won't tell you who it is and what they did for us at the time. They're not a vendor anymore, been a long time. But we flew out there, it was in 2013, early 2013, and we said, bring your technology guys. We want to talk about how to tap into your systems and get real-time data exchange between your systems and our systems. We go into the room, and the two guys who are the technology guys is the guy who plugs in the network cables and the guy installs Microsoft Outlook on your PC. Those were the two guys that were called technology guys, and they both fell asleep during the meeting. They both, by the way, flew to the meeting from somewhere else in the US, like gigantic waste of money and time. That wasn't so surprising, that these vendors were not going to be particularly technology oriented. And we generally can overcome those issues by just telling them, okay, just drop stuff on secure FTP servers, or whatever, or give us a raw data feed, we'll sort out ourselves and so on. But the second piece to me was surprising, that healthcare vendors don't live in environments where they get beaten down on their error rates. Healthcare tends to have a really 10 to 15% error rates where claims are wrongly coded, where transmissions get dropped and so on in ways that are very core to the way the business works. And nobody seems to really care all that much because, again, you and I, as the end users of this thing, are not the end customers. We don't make decisions. We get pissed off. We call a broker, we call an insurance company, complain about this stuff. But because of the complaining, an HR department is not going to drop Aetna United or whatever for the 40,000 members that they have. And so that's why we, in essence, then said we got to be full stack. We got to do everything ourselves. And we got to rebuild the systems from the ground up so that we now have our own claim system. We have our own processes around anything from utilization management to clinical research to obviously member services, even inside sales and so on. And you see the impact from that when one little data point, for example, not surprisingly there, you can make good decisions or not so great decisions when you select an insurance plan. And if you really want to feel stupid once in your life, and I'm sure people in this audience don't feel stupid all the time, all that much, because we're all pretty smart here, try to select an insurance plan. It makes you really feel like an idiot, deductibles and copays and all these things and these giant tables and everything. But there is an economically optimal choice you can make if you sort of know what your projected utilization will be, okay? When we look at who ends up in the optimally economical choice in among our members selecting insurance plans, when they call our team, our sales team of people on the phone, when you buy an insurance from Oscar, we make better decisions for them than if you go through brokers, which is sort of hilarious because brokers get paid shit tons of money for making decisions on your behalf and don't end up making particularly smart decisions oftentimes. And so long story short, this sort of like full stack approach, I think is the way to go. It's the harder way to go for sure, but it is the way to go. And the trajectory looks a little bit more like this, but then it gets more exponential the farther you get out on the curve.